Guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video, huh? Did he not behind the desk at the laptop? No, we are going to do some cool old-fashioned style again, walking and talking about Bitcoin, blockchain and life today. And because yes, the charts are very interesting, and yes, we are moving in this huge triangle, and yes, it is one of the most exciting moments when it comes to the breakout. Are we going to go up to 40k or are we going to go down to 30k? But yesterday, something way more exciting happened, and that is what we are going to talk today about as well. So let's jump into the video here while I show you the beautiful, amazing, that's double, area here in Hondón de las Frailes, Alicante, España. Bam! While filming the intro, yes, you saw this one. Oh, beautiful. I don't have only Bitcoins anymore. Now I also have a golden ring with some stones in it. And it was a present for my mother-in-law. It was one that belonged to her father. And now she gave it to me. It's like a zegelring, we call it in the Netherlands. I don't even know how you call it in English. But yeah, it's of course an honor to wear this ring that belonged to her father. And now it's belonging to me. And I will wear it proudly. Maybe I will be making a bee in it or something somewhere. We don't know. But yes, now I also own gold. I diversified my portfolio from Bitcoin also into gold, guys. Maybe I should step back again to Bitcoin. Why? Because yesterday, guys, this is the biggest news ever. This is the start of Plan B. Plan B. Hold all your Bitcoins now. Why? Because Plan B is taking action. It's getting started. I can't talk even anymore. It's getting started. El Salvador. That's what I'm talking about. El Salvador. You need to shout it very loud, Didi. El Salvador. Why? Because El Salvador is the first country in the world that's going to put Bitcoin on the balance sheet as a reserve asset instead of the dollar. Or maybe together with the dollar in the beginning, but at the end, instead of the dollar. They are going to accept Bitcoin as a legal tender for El Salvador. Which means that that is the first country in the world that is exactly going to use Bitcoin for what it is built for. To give access to all the people in that country without the ownership of a bank account. This is huge. This is the biggest step ever, I think, made for Bitcoin. Because now, the people of El Salvador, of which 70 to 80% doesn't own a bank account, has access to the same currency that the government is backing up. So the government fully trusts Bitcoin to be that new currency that is not having the same inflation because it's backed up by the dollar, or because they are controlled by the dollar, or because they are controlled by US sanctions, or because that the Fed prints a shitload of new money every year again and again and again. And yes, by that strengthening the beautiful rich people of the US and Europe and the rest of the world, but not those people in those countries that don't have access to the banking system, they get weak in it. Because we print more, they will have weak economies. We are killing their economies by just printing more and more. And now El Salvador, the president yesterday at the Miami Bitcoin conference announced through a video, we are now going to use Bitcoin. Because we need to protect our citizens, we need to protect the capital of the citizens, and we need to have a bright future for our citizens. And the only way to do this is to go with the flow and the evolution of money and store of value, and that one is called Bitcoin at the moment. So El Salvador is the first country that really is going to use Bitcoin for what it is built for the people. That is a president that I can respect. A president that takes really cool, strange actions, but he knows it's good for the people. And not only for the rich people in El Salvador, but also the poor people in El Salvador. And that is how every president should act. That is why we call it the Bitcoin standard. That is what the standard will be in a couple of years. When one sheep is over the dam, the rest will follow. And El Salvador is the first country, but many, many, many other countries will follow. Because they will see the economy and the store of value for the citizens. And they will see that it all is being positive influenced by Bitcoin in El Salvador. And other countries that are having the same issues as El Salvador will do the same. There are a shitload of countries in the world that have that same problem, guys. Inflation, because we print more and more money, their economies become worse and worse and worse. And that is now going to be solved by the Bitcoin. Bitcoin solves this. Yes, an amazing view, an amazing story, and I want to give a huge shout out to the guy, I forgot his name, sorry, that yesterday did the presentation. He was very emotional. He's the founder of Strike. He's the founder of Stripe, one of those two. And he is making it possible now for those people by using the Lightning Network to transact value with Bitcoin without these huge fees. So yes, the Lightning Network is going to take a huge role in this and make it possible for those people to transact value without having too high fees. Huge shout out to him for doing this. A huge shout out for him showing his realness on stage. That is what we need more. Not these fake people that pretend to be Bitcoiners or pretend to be changing the world, but only fill their own pockets again. We need more people like him. More people that really feel how bad the situation is in some parts of the world. And more people that not only feel that, but also want to take action. Doing, think of I am doing. Traveling around the world, helping people all over the world where I can, sharing my wealth, and by that help it and lead by example for others. Shout out, guys. Huge shout out. That was all about El Salvador. Huge news, and I needed to walk in this beautiful part of nature to tell you guys that. Now, let's talk about the Bitcoin price a little bit as well. The Bitcoin price, guys. As you can see on this chart, bam, we are moving in this huge triangle. And this huge triangle, yesterday we broke downwards out of that triangle. And because of breaking downwards, we all thought, okay, this is the moment. Now we is over. We are going to crash to 30K. Because that, even 23, 24K should be the target when we take the width of the triangle in the beginning and we paste it to the bottom, then you should see a breakout to 23, 24K as a result. But it is a huge fight. It is a huge fight between the bears and the bulls. And the bears and the bulls, you can see it in the charts, they are fighting. And now this small green candle is again trying to get back into that triangle. And that is a huge game to see if you're trading every day. For me, it's beautiful. It's like a football match or any other match, because you can see the bears and the bulls fighting to win this breakout. And in my opinion, with this bullish news of El Salvador and many other bullish news to come because of Apple and all these billion-dollar companies adding Bitcoin as well to their balance sheets, I think the breakout should be happening to the upside. But because of the leverage trading and all the stuff that is happening nowadays, it is never easy to predict. So the best thing you can do if you want to multiply your Bitcoins now is to trade the direction Bitcoin will go. And yes, we can stress about that it goes to 25k or the 50k, but you can either way earn more Bitcoins. And I think if you look now into the future and see what happened now with El Salvador, and you can see that there's going to happen more and more all over the world, then you need to understand that you need to start to accumulate Bitcoin, but most of important, HODL it. Accumulate, HODL. Believe in plan B. Accumulate and HODL. That is the most important message of today. Zoom out on those small time frame charts. Zoom in at life, enjoy these beautiful views, enjoy the things that you don't want to do on Sunday. And at the same time, make sure you accumulate Bitcoin by trading. And for that, yes, we created some indicators, the Didi Bam Bam indicator, the TikTok indicator, that will make it more easy for you to understand when to go long or short, or when to buy or when to sell. If you want more information about these indicators, then go to ddbam.com or to thebitcoinfamily.com. On thebitcoinfamily.com, you will find all the information. And if I were you, I would sign up now, because we will soon come out with some updates, and then you will still be included in these updates. In my opinion, this decade will be about letting the money work for you. It's not the 90s anymore. You don't need to work physically anymore to make money. You can now have the money work for you. I have trading bots. They make me every day an income. It's the best employee ever. Never wants a holiday. Never is complaining. Never is, no. It is trading 24/7 and making me Bitcoins. And by that, I don't need to work anymore. I let my capital work for me. And yes, I know there are people that don't have a starting capital. Start small and you will become big. Start with adding $10 of Bitcoin every week or every month. At the end, you will come into a situation that you will be able to let the capital work for you. And that is what you do by hodling Bitcoins. If you hodl Bitcoins now, in a year or 2 years, or maybe at the top of the next cycle in 2025, those Bitcoins will be increased in value tremendously. And that will give you that capital to let the capital work for you and not you work anymore for the money. Because the moment you are dependent on a job that is not in control by you, but you do it to earn money, that is the moment you are living a little bit in captivity, because the job and the boss that runs that company owns you. He wants you to perform 8 hours a day, maybe 10 hours a day. You need to do all the shit that you maybe don't want to do, but just to earn that money that you need to live. So in my opinion, the combination of minimalizing the cost, not having too much monthly cost by selling the house, selling everything else you have, you can minimize the cost tremendously by not having a mortgage and all that stuff, and just travel and live in cheap countries. And at the same time, starting to manage your portfolio, your capital, whatever it might be, is the solution for the future. That is what I lead by example, by took for my kids, because I believe they need to learn to understand that game. They don't need to be on schools to learn the game of how to run the hamster wheel. I don't want my kids to run the hamster wheel. I want my kids to enjoy life to the fullest while their capital is working for them. That is why I was so happy that Julie yesterday for her birthday asked Bitcoins. She received Bitcoins from me, and she has been receiving her allowance in Bitcoins as well. But normally she was like, my birthday present, I still want to have some clothes or Nikes, whatever shoes. This time she said, no, Dad, I just want Bitcoin. I have everything I need. I have all the clothes. I have all my makeup, just Bitcoin. And that is why we gave her Bitcoin. That was a huge moment for me, because it was a sweet 16th birthday. Because of all the lockdowns and all the shit about the flu, we couldn't give her the sweet 16 she wanted and she deserved, with all the friends in a beautiful, party environment. But we will do that when everything is over, or when we settle down in the place where we are allowed to give a huge party. And I will invite her friends from the Netherlands and fly her with cheap tickets to us to have that sweet 16 party. That's a promise, Julie, that's a promise. Guys, that was everything for today. I hope you really enjoyed this video. I hope you really enjoyed the views again. And if you did enjoy the video, please give the video a thumbs up, share with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and please leave me a comment. I would love to hear from you guys. Would you prefer to me do these videos again a little bit more often, walk and talk, or do you prefer the classical TA videos behind the computer, short, powerful TA? And maybe even you prefer the combination of these walk and talks and those classical TA videos. So let me know down below in the comments what you think about the price, what is your opinion about El Salvador saving the world by giving everybody in that country hope, and by giving them hope, they are leading by example as a country, and by leading by example as a country, other countries will follow and other citizens will get hope as well, and they will all see now a positive, bright future ahead instead of the enslaved future because of full control of those governments that are now using some kind of a flu and all other stuff to take control on humanity. Thanks for watching, guys, and hopefully see you tomorrow again on Monday. Maybe later today I will do an English AMA, but let's see if I have still have like time on Sunday, because also I need to zoom out a little bit and zoom in a little bit more in life, because else I'm only working again. But guys, I need more followers. Share this, share my videos, tell them this Google guy is really huddling, this guy is really all in, and yes, you should watch his channel because he deserves 100k followers as well. Mucho gracias for visitar la YouTube channel, the Bitcoin family, that was French and Spanish through each other, and see you tomorrow again, guys. Bye bye, bam.